हे क्लास, हाय, हेलो, नमस्ते, आदाब, सत श्री अकाल, अस्सलाम वालेकुम एंड वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू. वेलकम वंस अगेन टू टुडेस सेशन व्हिच इज योर उमंग सीरीज फॉर योर ग्रेड 9. एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट लीनियर इक्वेशंस इनटू वेरिएबल्स. एज यू वर टेलिंग मी दैट सर स्टार्ट दैट चैप्टर लीनियर इक्वेशन इनटू वेरिएबल्स, सो वी आर फाइनली स्टार्टिंग विद द चैप्टर लीनियर इक्वेशंस इनटू वेरिएबल्स. गॉट इट? So in this session, you are going to learn a new type of equations. That means there will be two variables and it will be linear in form. Okay, so this equation we are going to study today. So let us start the class with the linear equation in two variables. Now in this chapter today, we are going to study about the solutions of linear equation in two variables. The next session will be how to plot the graph and some questions related to it. And then the third session will be your doubt plus mentee series. Okay. So these are going to be your three sessions for this topic. Now let us start the session. So the first part which we are going to study about the linear equation in two variables. So first let us understand that what is a linear equation in two variables. Okay. So as the name suggests, linear equation in two variables. Okay. So this part is pretty much clear that there will be two variables. Okay. You can say x and y. Let us say there will be two variables, x and y. And linear means what? Degree. So degree of the equation will be 1. If degree is 1, we have learned it in the topic polynomial that if degree is 1, it is called a linear equation, right? So the degree should be 1. Degree means highest power of the variable should be 1. So a linear equation in two variables, how it will be formed? There you go. One term will be for x, one x term will be there. It cannot have x square x cube because then it will no longer be a linear equation. One term will be of y and one will be a constant term. Correct. Now this x term can have any coefficient a. This y term can have any coefficient b. So ax plus by plus c equal to 0 is the general form for a linear equation in two variables. Ax plus by plus c equal to 0 is the general form for a linear equation in two variable, right? Now in this part, beta, first understand that you have been given this equation. Now what are the conditions? First condition is that a cannot be equal to 0 and b cannot be equal to 0. Got it? Both a and b cannot be equal to 0. One at a time can be 0. One can be 0, no problem in that. But both cannot be 0 because then you will be left only with a constant term c. Got it? So that is the first rule, that both cannot be equal to 0. Then comes the second part, that a, b and c are real numbers. So this is the condition for a linear equation in two variable. One is ax plus by plus c. This is the general form. What is this? This is your general form for a linear equation in two variables. So you can see that we have two variables. Coefficient of x is a, coefficient of y is b, and constant term c is equal to 0. So this is the general form, very important form. You should always remember the general form. And the condition is a and b both cannot be equal to 0, and a, b and c has to be a real number. So let us first understand that how can I represent any equation. If any linear equation is given to me, how to find out the value of a, value of b, value of c, and so on. Okay, so for example, dekho, if I give you some equation, let us say I have given you an equation, let's say 2x plus 3y equal to 9. Now understand, as I have told you, the general form ax plus by plus c equal to 0. So equal to 0 has to be created. So here you will say, sir, write it as 2x plus 3y minus 9 equal to 0. Correct? Now compare it with the general form ax plus by plus c equal to 0. So you will get a is equal to 2, b is equal to 3, and c is equal to what? C is equal to, I want to get the answer from all of you. What should be c equal to? Is it 9? Or it is minus 9. What it should be? Think about it. Okay. So the value for C will be, as you know, value of C will be minus 9. Because beta, dekho na, this negative signs also has to be taken with it. देखो हियर इट इज व्हाट प्लस सी, हियर इट इज माइनस 9, सो प्लस सी इज इक्वल टू माइनस 9, दैट मींस सी इज इक्वल टू 9. सो एनीवेयर यू सी द नेगेटिव साइन ऑलवेज रिमेंबर दैट द नेगेटिव हैज टू बी टेकन. लेट्स टेक वन मोर एग्जांपल. लेट अस आई हैव गिवन यू से 2x minus 3y minus 5 equal to 0. Now, no need to do any changes because this equation is already in the general form. Equal to 0 is already there. So, I can say a is equal to 2, b is equal to minus 3 and c is equal to minus 5. Okay. Now, sometimes suppose if I write it like this, suppose 3y plus 5 is equal to minus 7x. Let's say this is what I have given to you. Okay. Now in this case, again, you can see it is not in the general form. It is not in the general form. So you can convert it into general form. One is shift minus 7x over there. So if I shift this minus 7x over there, minus 7x will become plus 7x. Then plus 3y plus 5 equal to 0. So comparing it, coefficient of x is a, so 7, coefficient of y is b, which is 3, and constant of c is 5. Other way is, ki sir, instead of shifting minus 7x over there, what if I shift 3y plus 5 over to this side? So in that case, your equation will become minus 7x is already here, 3y shifted here will become minus 3y, and plus 5 shifted here will become minus 5 equal to 0. Correct? So a will be equal to minus 7, b will be equal to minus 3 and c will be equal to minus 5. So now tell me which one will you get, tell me which one is correct, either this one or this one. What do you think, which of the answer is correct one? A is equal to 7, b is equal to 3 or c is equal to 5, or a is equal to minus 7, b is equal to minus 3 or c is equal to minus 5. Which one is the correct answer? Okay, so as you must be voting, some are saying A, some are saying B, and some of you must be saying that sir, both are correct, and actually both are correct. Both are correct because they both are representing the same equation. By either shift this minus 7x over there or shift this 3y plus 5 over here, at the end your equation remains same. If you take negative 1 common, you will get minus of 7x plus 3y plus 5 equal to 0, shift negative over there, again you will be getting the same equation. So both are representing the same equation. So this is also correct and this is also correct. Both are your correct answer. Okay. So it doesn't matter whether or everything you are shifting to LHS or everything you are shifting to RHS, the values of A, B and C, any one of them will be correct. Any one of them will be correct. Okay. So this is how it will be working. So let's look at some questions now. ठीक है, तो देखो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज एक्सप्रेस दिस x माइनस y बाय 5 माइनस 10 इक्वल टू 0, व्हाट इज a b एंड c. सो द इक्वेशन इज x माइनस y बाय 5 माइनस 10 इक्वल टू 0. सो कोफिशियंट ऑफ x, कोफिशियंट मींस समथिंग दैट यू आर मल्टीप्लाइंग विद द वेरिएबल, द नंबर व्हिच इज बीइंग मल्टीप्लाइड विद द वेरिएबल. सो हियर x इज मल्टीप्लाइड विद 1. So a is equal to 1. I'm looking at the form ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Then y, here y is multiplied with what? Deko, look at minus y by 5. Minus y by 5 is nothing but minus of 1 by 5 into y. Right? So y is multiplied with minus 1 by 5. So I will say b is equal to minus 1 by 5. And c is equal to minus 10. And c is equal to minus 10. So these are your values. A is equal to 1. B is equal to minus 1 by 5. And c is equal to minus 10. Okay. Next question is this. X is equal to 3y. Ab dekho, is it in the general form? No, sir. Because we want equal to 0. So now either you can shift 3y over here or shift this x over here. Everything depends upon you. Suppose if I shift this x 3y over to LHS, so I will get x minus 3y equal to 0. Now compare it with this form ax plus by plus c equal to 0. So you will get coefficient of x, a is equal to 1. Coefficient of y, y is multiplied with minus 3, so b is equal to minus 3. And the constant term is not present here. So if the constant term is not present, I can say constant term is equal to 0, because if I write plus 0 here in this equation, if I write plus 0 here in this equation, the equation does not change. So if the constant term is not present, the value of the constant term C will be equal to 0. Okay, next question, 3x plus 2 equal to 0. Chalo. So I want you to tell me the values of A, B and C. I want you all to let me know in the chat box, what do you think is the value of A, is the value of B, and what is the value of C? I'm waiting for you all to answer to this question, values of A, B, and C. Okay, so now I will solve it. If you have not solved it till now, pause the video at this moment, write your answer and then see whether it is correct or not. So first thing you can see, equal to 0 is there. So it is already in that form, correct? Now, as you can see, y term is not present here. Y term is not present here. So how do I get y into this part? How do I get y into this part so that the equation does not change? So that the equation does not change. So beta, dekho, 3x plus 1 y term should be there, plus 2 equal to 0. Now if I just write y, if I just write y, it will change the equation. So what I will do, I will write y as 0 into y. I will write y as 0 into y. So you can see this was your linear equation in one variable, and now you have converted in two variables, correct? Where the second variable's coefficient is 0. So no matter what value of y is there, it is always becoming 0. So values of y does not matter, but we have converted into that form. Now remember, when I was teaching you the general form, I have told you both A and B should not be 0. Any one can be 0, no problem with that. Got it? So if any of the variable is not present, you can introduce that variable in that equation by making the coefficient of that variable 0. So 0 into y, if I write, it does not change the equation, because 0 into y is nothing but 0 only. So adding 0 does not change the equation. We know this part, right? So now it has been converted into that form. So I can say, sir, comparing it with ax plus by plus c equal to 0, I will get a is equal to 3, b is equal to 0, and c is equal to 2. So a is equal to 3, b is equal to 0, and c is equal to 2. Also, you can understand, dekho, when constant term was not present, its value was 0. Here, if the y term is not present, its coefficient is 0. Got it? And remember, both a and b together cannot be 0. One at a time 0 is there, no problem. Okay? So a is 3, b is 0, and c is equal to 2. Next question, 5 is equal to 2x. First thing, you can shift anyone to any side. You can shift either 5 to here, or you can shift 2x over there. Suppose if I shift this 5 to RHS, so you'll be getting 2x minus 5 is equal to 0. Now again you will see y term is not present. So how will I write y? I will write, so 2x plus y term will come here, and then minus 5 equal to 0. Now since y term is not present, I will write y term as 0 into y, correct? Because I know 0 into y is equal to 0. So if I compare it with the ax plus by plus c equal to 0, what I will be getting? I will be getting a equal to 2, b equal to 0, and c equal to 5. What do you think? Not 5, it is minus 5, because negative sign also has to be taken together. Negative sign also has to be taken together. Okay, another way, shift this minus 2x over here. So minus 2x plus 5 equal to 0. So minus 2x plus 0 into y plus 5 equal to 0. So a is equal to minus 2, b is equal to 0, and c is equal to 5. So either this or this, both are correct. Both are correct. Okay. Next question, let us try to frame one equation. Let us make the equation. Okay, so read the question once. I want you all to read this question once, what the question is trying to tell you, okay? And think that how you can write an equation for this part. So the question is telling that the cost of a notebook is twice the cost of a pen. Cost of a notebook is twice the cost of a pen. Write a linear equation in two variables to represent the statement. So I will see, I have two things here. One is the notebook and one is your pen. Correct? So if I say that let us take the cost of one notebook. Is equal to rupees X and cost of one pen is let us say rupees Y. Correct? So cost of one notebook is rupees X, cost of one pen is rupees Y. Write a linear equation. What is the statement? What is the relation given between them? Is cost of one notebook. What is cost of one notebook? X is means equal to twice means two into double of what? Cost of a pen, that is y. So equation is x is equal to 2y. So shift 2y over there. X minus 2y equal to 0 is your linear equation in two variables. This is your linear equation in two variables. So this is how you need to understand the concept behind that question, and you will be able to solve them. So the equation is x minus 2y is equal to 0. Okay, now so this was your general form, and we have learned how to make the equation. So the general form we have learned is ax plus by plus c equal to 0, where a, b and c are real numbers, a and b both cannot be 0. Okay, and if x term is not present, you will write 0 into x. For example, if I give you an equation, let us say 2y plus 3, what is the value of a, b and c? So since x is not present, what you are going to do here, you will make this x, you will write x as 0 into x. So x is equal, so I can say a is equal to 0, b is equal to 2 and c is equal to 3. Got it? So if constant term is not present, constant term will be 0. If y term is not present, its coefficient will be 0. And if x term is not present, its coefficient will be 0. So we have also learned that how do I convert a linear equation in one variable to a linear equation in two variable, right? Just whatever coefficient is not, whatever variable is not present, write that variable with coefficient 0. That is very important. Don't just write y, it will be wrong. Coefficient of that variable which was not present originally in the equation should be 0. So 0 into y you have to add here. So 3x plus 2 is a linear equation in one variable. To convert it in linear equation in two variable, you have done 3x plus 0 into y plus 2 equal to 0. Got it? So these are all the questions related to your general form for a linear equation in two variable. Now let us go for the solution of a linear equation in two variable. Better dekho, what do you mean by solution? Solution means the values of variable. The values of variable for which the equation will be satisfied, LHS will be equal to RHS. For example, if I give you an equation x plus y is equal to 1. X plus y is equal to 1. Now, if you want to find out the solution here, dekho, one method I am telling you. First method I am telling you, ki chalo sir, what I'll do na, assume any value of x. So suppose if I assume x is equal to 0 and then tell me what will be y. So I will say x is 0 plus y is equal to 1. So y is equal to 1. Correct? So x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1 is satisfying this equation, yes or no? Ha sir, put x is equal to 0 plus 1 is equal to 1 only. Ha sir, it is satisfying. So x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1 is a solution. Okay? And the solutions can be written in the form of this form, x, y. We write the solution. We can also write the solution of x and y in this form, x, y. First, you will write the value of x, then you will write the value of y. So 0, 1 is the solution of this equation. First, value of x, then value of y, like you write the coordinates. I will show you this relation in the next session. Why do we write it in this form? Okay, so this is your one solution. Now tell me, I have got the solution by assuming x is equal to 0. But is it fixed that every time I assume 0 only? Can I not assume it any other value? So can I take any other value of x? What do you think? I can take any other value of x also. What do you think about it? Can I take any other value of x? For example, let us take sir x is equal to 1. Chalo, let's try that. What do you think? I must be sure. You must be telling me, sir, you can take. So let us take. So now I'm taking x is equal to 1 and let us see y is equal to what. So x is equal to 1 plus y is equal to 1. Shift this 1 over there. You'll be getting y is equal to 0. So here you have got the solution as x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 0. So the solution form, how you can write it? Always x comma y. So x is equal to 1. Y is equal to 0. This is one more solution. Correct? Similarly, you can take the value of x as 2 also, x as 3 also, x as 4 also, x as 5 also. You can take the value of y also. It is not necessary that every time you will start with the value of x only. You can start with the value of y as well. For example, now I will take y as, let us say, minus 2. And let's see what is x. So x plus minus 2 is equal to 0. So sorry, my x plus minus 2 is equal to 1. So x minus 2 is equal to 1. So you will be getting minus 2 today will become plus 2. So that is x is equal to 3. So what you have got, beta? Your value of x is equal to 3. Now how do I write this solution? You always know first x and then y. So first the value of x and then the value of y. You cannot write the value of y first and x later. No. Always x comma y. So 3 comma minus 2 is your one more solution. So in this way, beta, I can find out infinite solution. Because I can take infinite values of x. X can be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 3, minus 1 by 4. Infinite values. Infinite values are there. So for all these infinite values, there will be infinite solutions. So I can say that if I have a linear equation in two variable, always remember, a linear equation in two variables, a linear equation in two variables have infinite solution. How many solutions? Infinite solutions it has. A linear equation in two variables have infinite solution, as many solutions as you want. Got it? Ab dekho beta, and I have told you how do you get the solution. Assume, so how to get the solution? So step one, choose any one variable. That means you can either choose x or y, anything you want, and assume any value of it. Whatever you want. 0, 2, 3, minus 5, minus 1 by 2, whatever it is. Second part, put that value in the equation to get value of the other variable. Correct? So this is how you can get the solution for any linear equation in two variable. But here the most important part, beta, which I have told you right now, is that a linear equation in two variable have infinite solution. Very important part. Remember, a linear equation in two variable have infinite solution because you can assume infinite values for any variable and you will get one more value for the other variable. So let us take one more example. Let us say we have been given as 2x plus 4y is equal to 16. If I start with, suppose if I choose x, so if I take x as 1, let us see what will be y. I want you all to tell me what will be your value of y. Put x as 1 and tell me what will be your values of y. Okay. It is not necessary every time you are getting integer answers. It is not necessary that every time you will get integer answer. Just tell me what do you think is the value of y. Okay, so I'm pretty sure all of you have started giving the answer by now. If you have not solved it, pause the video right over here and then see the solution. So put x is equal to 1 in this part. So 2 into 1 plus 4y is equal to 16. So 2 into 1 is 2 plus 4y is equal to 16. Shift 2 over there, 4y is equal to 14. 16 minus 2 is 14. So y is equal to 14 by 4, which means 3.5. So when x is equal to 1, I can say y is equal to 3.5. So one solution is x comma y. This is your one solution. One more solution if you want to find out. Now let us assume the value of y. Let us assume the value of y. Let us assume y is equal to 0. Then let's see what is the value of x. Yep, let me know what should be your values of x. What should be your values of x? If y is 0, what is your values of x? Very good. I'm pretty sure all of you are giving the correct answer. So put y is equal to 0 in this equation. So 2x plus 4 into 0 is equal to 16. So 4 into 0 is what? 0 only. So 2x is equal to 16 and x is equal to 8. So how do you write this solution? First the value of x, which is 8, and then the value of y, which is 0. So this is also one more solution. So this is how you can get the infinite solutions you want. Okay, chalo. So now let us write four solutions for each of the equations. 2x plus y is equal to 7. So beta, we can easily do this part. Let us start with first value of x is equal to 0 and value of y is equal to what? So 2 into 0 plus y is equal to 7. 2 into 0 is 0, so y is equal to 7. Second part, first value, second value, you can say that sir, put x is equal to 1 and let us see what is the value of y. So 2 into 1 plus y is equal to 7. So y is equal to 2 into 1 is 2, 7 minus 2 is 5. So y is equal to 5. Third, you can say that sir, let us put x is equal to 2 and let us see what is the value of y. So 2 into 2, which is 4, plus y is equal to 7. So y is equal to 7 minus 4, which is equal to 3. So y is equal to 3. And then one more solution you can get, that suppose x is equal to 3, then what will be the value of y? So 2 into 3 plus y equal to 7. So y is equal to 7 minus 6, which means 1. So these are your four solutions for this equation 2x plus y is equal to 7. Now it is not necessary you will only take x as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. You can take x as minus 1 also, minus 2 also. There are infinite solutions. So your solutions might be different than mine. But if you have taken x is equal to 0, definitely y will be 7. It cannot be like you are also solving for x is equal to 0 and you are getting y as something else. That is not possible. If you are taking some different values of x, different values of y you will be getting. But if you are taking x is equal to 1, y will always be 5 for this equation. Okay, so this is how you can get the infinite solutions. So here, as you can see, they have taken the solution for x is equal to 0, y is equal to 7. For y is equal to 0, x is 7 by 2. When x is equal to 1, y is 5. When y is equal to 1, x is equal to 3. So these are your four solutions. Got it? Infinite solutions are there. Write any four out of them. Okay, chalo. Next question. This question is very important. Check which of the following are the solutions of the equation x minus 2y is equal to 4. So we have been given 4 comma 0. I have told you it is given in the form of x comma y. Now whenever we talk about the solution of any equation, we know that if any value is a solution, LHS should be equal to RHS. Correct? LHS should be equal to RHS. So I got to know that my RHS is equal to 4. Let us see what is my LHS. My LHS, in this LHS, I will put x is equal to 4 and y is equal to 0. So tell me beta whether it will satisfy or not. Whether it will satisfy or not. What do you think? Yes, it is satisfying. 4 minus 2 into 0. LHS is this. So 4 minus 0, which means 4. So you can see LHS is equal to 4. RHS is also equal to 4. So you have got LHS is equal to RHS. So I can say it is a solution. Okay, let's go for the next part. Check which of the following. So x minus 2y is equal to 4. Again, same equation. Tell me whether this one is a solution or not. Root 2 comma 4 root 2. Let me know about it. I want all of you to solve this question. Pause this video and solve it. And after that, you can start resuming it again so that you can see the solution. I will solve it now. Those who want to solve it more on their own, pause this video, solve it, and then look the solution. So here you have x minus 2y is equal to 4. Your RHS you know is 4. Let us see what is LHS. So LHS is x. So here I know in LHS I will put x is equal to root 2 and y is equal to 4 root 2. Correct? So equation will become root 2 minus 2 times of 4 root 2. So root 2 minus 4 2s are 8. Minus 8 root 2, which means minus 7 root 2. So your LHS is equal to minus 7 root 2. RHS is equal to 4. So you can clearly see LHS is not equal to RHS. And I can say this one is not a solution. This is not a solution. Okay, because LHS is not equal to RHS. Now, let's look at a very interesting question. This question, these kind of questions are very important. Find the value of k if x is equal to 2, y is equal to 1. Is the solution of the equation 2x plus 3y is equal to k? So, beta, here they have already given that x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 1 is the solution. Okay. X is equal to 2 and y is equal to 1 is solution of 2x plus 3y equal to k. Now, beta, I know that if they are solution, if x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 1, I know that LHS and RHS should balance itself. Obviously, this equation should be satisfied. So, I will say that 2x plus 3y equal to k should be satisfied if at x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 1. So it is satisfied. So let us put the value of x and y here. So 2 into 2 plus 3 into y is what? 1 is equal to k. 2 into 2 is 4 plus 3 is equal to k. So you have got k is equal to 4 plus 3, which is 7. Okay, beta. So this is how you have got that k is equal to 7. Now, how do I got to know that it will be satisfying? Because how do I know x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 1 will satisfy this equation? Because it is given that they are the solution. They are already the solution. So I am definitely sure that LHS will be equal to RHS. No problem behind it. Got it? So this is how you have got the value of k. Very important question. Very important question. Now related to this question, I am giving you one question for your homework. This is your homework. If 4,19 is a solution of the equation y is equal to ax plus 3, then what is the value of a? Take a screenshot, solve it, and write your answer in the comment section. I want you to write the answer in the comment section so that I can go through it. Okay. Even though you are sending your answer in the chat box, still don't forget to write the answer in the comment section, because from there I will get to see how many of you have given the answers correctly. So if you have solved it, beta, please don't forget to comment your answer in the homework section. Okay, so this is all in today's class. And I have a very exciting news for you all today. A very exciting news. First is your VSET. All of you all know that vdnt.in/ytvset. This is the link to register for VSET. Why you should give VSET? First thing, online test, no need to go anywhere out. Second thing, not a single rupee fee for the registration. Free registration and scholarship. You are getting scholarship as well. Got it? So many students have already won the scholarships. Why you are waiting for? As you remember, I was telling you, I have a very exciting news for you. The exciting news is Vedantu Pro subscription. So the link to register. Let me tell you first, what is this part? सो हाउ डू यू कैन हाउ यू कैन रजिस्टर फॉर दिस लिंक, तो बेटा याद रखना, फर्स्ट थिंग व्हाट यू नीड टू डू इज यू नीड टू गो टू द लिंक vdnt.in/ytpro. दिस इज द लिंक, ओके, ytpro इन द कैपिटल, yt स्टैंड्स फॉर यूट्यूब, pro इज द प्रो सब्सक्रिप्शन. So VDNT short for vedantu.in/ytpro. The link is also available in the description if you want to register for here. Then after going there, what will happen here? That you will be taken to this page. You will see this. So in pro, select your grade, grade 9. Select your target, CBSE 2021. Okay, that is your part, grade 9, CBSE 2021. After that, you will click on get subscription. You will click on get subscription. Once you will click on the get subscription part, if you choose the 1 month part, you will be showing 4000. But apply the code GPPRO. GP is my first name initials, Gopal Paliwal. So GP and Pro is your course. So GP Pro, apply in the coupon code and instantly you will get the discount. From 4000, it will become rupees 2000. 699. So 1301 rupees discount will be given here. You can also choose it for 3 months also and 6 months also. The more number of months you will choose, the less price you will be getting. Got it? The code is same, GPPRO. Okay, so this was the part. Now in this pro course, first thing, you are getting personalized attention, full live classes, recordings also you'll get, notes, assignment, test, leaderboard, all the Vedanta classes you are going to enjoy. Also, the structure, the complete curriculum will be provided. Okay, structured long-term courses will be there. All chapter-wise micro courses will be completed. Complete crash course will also be done. You can also plan your own study. Okay, you can also plan to read, to understand that which chapter you want to study first, because modular courses will also be there. So you can build your own curriculum. I can see many students will tell me, sir, teach this part, teach that part, sir, teach this chapter first. So that freedom you will be having when you will be having this pro subscription. You can choose whatever subject, whatever chapter you want to learn first. And long-term courses also are there. Along with that, test series, assignments, learning material, everything will be provided to you. Okay. So I would suggest all of you, it's a very small deal. Because it is not only because just because you are watching my video, you are applying this course so only for maths. No, it is for your maths, physics, chemistry, biology, social science and English. All the six subjects will be covered just at this price. You go for tuition for all the subjects, you will not be able to get such a price what Vedanta is offering right now. This is a deal you should not back it out from. I would suggest those who can join. Those who can join, do not worry about anything. You are already familiar with all of us. You should join this course. You are going to love it. Okay. So this is all better from my side. Thank you so much for attending the session. And don't forget to like this video. Share this video with your friends. Sir, I cannot see many shares. Share. You are not sharing with your friends. The number of students are not increasing. So please share it with your friends. And those my new students who are new here, who have not subscribed to this channel yet, do not forget to subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon. Got it? So this is all from my side in today's class. Thank you so much, beta. And I'll see you soon. Till then, bye-bye. Khuda hafiz.